Hi, my name is Harold Fave. It's June 1st, 2014. We're going to take a ride out to GREC Biomass Plant and do our own private investigation for fugitive dust coming out of the plant in various locations, and we'll give a report back at the end of this video.
And here we are already at the entrance to the biomass plant, and they've put a solid gate as a barrier here where only a guard shack existed at one time. And here we are exiting the biomass plant and running into a speed bump that reveals fugitive dust in the form of these chips is littering the highway. Each time a truck exits, it reveals that the load has not been fully deployed, and some of the load and the chips and the fugitive dust is escaping from the trucks. And of course, a lot of it is still on the truck when it leaves at this exit ramp, and we see it right there on the road. It mixes with the traffic. Department of Transportation may find that it increases the braking distance, all kinds of aftermath, and there some of the fugitive dust is embedded in the roadside. And the trucks travel northbound and pass right in front of the Alachua County Public Works Department. And we'll stop here and take a look at this roadside to inspect the evidence of fugitive dust and chips that continue to fall off the truck as it travels northbound into Hague. And here we see plenty of evidence of fugitive dust, even on this road as they travel northbound. They've gained some speed, and the fugitive dust just keeps falling out of the trucks and littering the highway. The odor here at the Public Works Department is burning my eyes with a sickening sweet odor, the same as it was at all locations inside and outside the biomass plant and at the speed bump and outside the gate. And here we are even further northbound. We're into Hague right now, and we're looking at this intersection at CR 237, and we see more evidence of fugitive dust as the trucks stop and take off again at this intersection. So we're about a mile from the biomass plant right now, and it's been raining a lot, and a lot of this has been washed out. We're at 128th lane now. We're going to travel into the back of the biomass plant, and here's the end of the paved road, and we're going to look for evidence of fugitive dust and chips. And we see a few here, although it's not conclusive. There's a suggestion. We see deep ruts in front of this back gate where they're not supposed to be transiting biomass chips through this gate, and it looks like there is no evidence for that. However, there are some deep ruts in the side of the road here, and photographic evidence of some activity that involves heavy trucks, loaded trucks. Of course, the rain has been pretty hard, and it could allow for a lot of different scenarios. We look back and we see some evidence of disruption, but really nothing through the gate, as the apron there at the back gate looks pretty clean and untraversed by heavy trucks, although the view is interesting. So what does the EPA say about sources of fugitive dust? Quoting from the EPA 13.2 document, fugitive dust sources: significant atmospheric dust arises from the mechanical disturbance of granular material exposed to the air. Dust generated from these open sources is termed, quote, fugitive, unquote, because it is not discharged to the atmosphere in a confined flow stream. Common sources of fugitive dust include unpaved roads, agricultural tilling operations, aggregate storage piles, and heavy construction operations. For the above sources of fugitive dust, the dust generation process is caused by two basic physical phenomena. Number one, pulverization and abrasion of surface materials by application of mechanical force through implements such as wheels, blades, etc. Number two, entrainment of dust particles by the action of turbulent air currents such as wind erosion of an exposed surface by wind speeds over 12 miles per hour. The county doesn't need $96,000 in 9 months to discover that GREC has had a whopping fugitive dust problem since September of 2013. The chips have been ground into fine particulates by the abrasion of thousands of car and truck tires for the past 8 months. Please click on the link in the comments section to view the complete article associated with this video.